Elliotts was the hardest work because I was using my hands all the time. I worked with a friend of mine because it was much better work, the pay, than the job I was working before. And I had a friend that went there with me, you see, Amy Clarid. Whatever Amy wanted to do, we did. Not what I wanted to do, but she was very bossy. Oh, but my mother was, all the time I was there, she was straight at me. Oh, you are a silly girl, silly girl. You make me and your dad so nervous that you... I said, why? Because you're more likely to get killed, she said. I said, no, I'm not. I could get walk out this door now and get killed. was all women. Mm. There's very few. Only the top charge hands. Mm. I think we only, with all the girls that was there, there was a lot of girls, I couldn't tell you how many, but there was at least 200. Mm. I was strong then, I could do it. No, I could do it. But the men were good to me. The two or three that was there, come on Vera, we'll do that, you're too little to do that. And they used to do it. Lots of all the different machines, see. It was a big building. Very noisy, very noisy. The sound of all the machines going. We had a good year's training. Well, it's a very, very tricky thing to learn, really. Machines kept running. There was only about 4 men, as I said there. And the men were going on. But they never stopped at all, all through the war. They were kept running quite hot. We did have air conditioning in there, but they'd only just started it just towards the end when I could leave there. I wanted to get out of there as soon as I could. Not just to please Mum, I didn't like it because you used to get all this sawdust flying about.
Yeah.
And it used to get down my throat.
Yeah.
I could taste it. Painty smell. Oh, and the smell of steel, because that smells when it's hot, smells horrible. I know, I was at a dance one night and this bloke said to me, "Sorry to ask you," he said, "I don't mean it, but you've got smell of paint." "And you're lovely and clean and look so smart." I said, "No, that's the smell of where I work." You couldn't get a smell out of it. Just fun with the girls and, well, and the men, as I said, there was about four men there, but they were very good to us. If they saw that you couldn't lift something, they'd be there and do it for you, which we supposed to have done ourselves. And we used to shout across to each other, "Is it time to go home yet? Don't forget where we're going tonight," and we were going out to a dance and stuff. Now, what you do when you're young? I had some good friends there. Went to work as a barmaid, and there were still a few men that knew me, and they knew that I worked there. They used to come in, but I told them no. I said, "I'd rather you didn't," so I stopped them coming in. I didn't want them coming in there. I didn't want them to know that I worked in the factory. But when the landlady found out, she said, "Oh, Vera, you are silly. You were brave to do that work." So she said, "I'm going to tell him tonight." I said, "Oh, all right, as long as you say, Gay." And she told him, and they brought the pub a drink. We all had an extra drink. And I had a whiskey and dry, which perked me up.
That must have made you feel quite proud that other people felt like that about...
Oh, it did, yeah, it did.